Welcome back, and in this part of the course, I want to cover two main topics. I'll start by stepping through container architecture, and then I'll cover some of the high-level benefits of containers. At this level, you can think of containers and Docker as roughly the same thing. A Docker container is a type of container. The difference doesn't matter until we go much deeper into the tech. Now, before we move on, if you haven't watched my video on physical servers versus virtual machines, then go ahead and do that now before continuing with this video. At this point though, let's jump in and get started. Now, as a reminder, with a virtual machine architecture, we have physical hardware, commonly referred to as a VM host. On top of that, either the hypervisor is running directly or a host OS and then the hypervisor. This is the difference between, say, VirtualBox, which runs on an operating system, versus VMware, which runs directly on the host. Then we have virtual machines, each of which runs its own guest operating system, which could be the same operating system, for example, all Debian, or they could each be different guest operating systems. And then running inside of the guest operating systems, we have our applications, as well as any libraries or runtime environments. Now, you'll recall from the video where I covered this, I mentioned that running multiple guest operating systems is actually very costly in terms of resources, and this can actually be the cause of large-scale duplication if many copies of the same operating system are used. It also means, because each virtual machine needs to start up its own operating system, there's also added overhead in terms of startup and restarts, although this is less than with physical servers. Now let's compare this to containers. We start with the same hardware, and we'll refer to this as a Docker host or container host, and on top of this is a host operating system. On top of this is a container engine. In the case of Docker, this is called Docker Engine. Now, so far, this might look familiar, but there are a few key differences. First, the Docker or container engine, by comparison, is generally lighter than a hypervisor because it has less to do. Secondly, any containers running on this Docker host, they share the same host operating system. They run as a process in that operating system. It means that containers don't need to run their own individual operating systems. They only need to run the libraries and runtime environment and the application itself. Because of this, containers are much smaller and more lightweight versus the same application running within a virtual machine. It means that on a given piece of physical hardware, running containers versus virtual machines results in more free capacity. It means you can run a smaller host or use the same host but pack in more containers, resulting in better utilization and thus more value for a business. Now, from a high-level perspective, that's the main differences between how you run virtual machines and containers. Let's finish up by stepping through some of the main summary points that you'll need to understand. Now, some of these are repeats, but I just want to make absolutely sure that you 100% understand them. First, containers run on a container host. This is the physical hardware, and they run via a container engine. In the case of Docker, this is called Docker Engine. Now, a container only contains an application, its libraries, and any runtime environments required. They don't contain any operating system, because they share the operating system running on the container host. Each container runs as a process within this host operating system. Now, this means containers are super lightweight and can be densely packed onto a host and started or restarted quickly. Not having to start or restart an entire operating system for each container is a substantial amount of overhead which is removed. Now, containers can be impacted by other containers. This is a downside of sharing the container host operating system. It's just a process within that operating system. While the container host OS might have ways to control the amount of resource allocation a process gets, it's never going to be as tightly controlled and isolated as virtual machines. If one container is noisy, i.e. consuming a massive amount of CPU or memory, other containers can be impacted. Just imagine somebody playing loud music at 2 a.m. in a neighbouring apartment. If you live close to this apartment, you'll be able to hear this music. And this is the same with containers, because they're not strongly isolated from other containers, any container aggressively using resources on the container host can impact other containers. Now, there are some ways on modern container engines that this is minimized, but it's something that you should keep in mind. Now, the best explanation that I've heard to understand containers is this. They were created to fix an application shipping problem, where an application was developed on a developer's machine but didn't work when deployed into production. This led to the famous line of "it works on my computer," and well, containers are a way to ship that very computer. Containers are designed to hold an application as well as everything that application needs to function. This means specific, tested, known working versions of libraries. Once you know the container works, you know it works anywhere that that container runs. Okay, so that's everything I wanted to cover for now. Thanks for watching. When you're ready, I'll see you in the next part of the course.